All right, so in this lesson here, we're going to be solving systems of equations by graphing. So a system of equations is when you have more than one equation and more than one variable to solve for. So the solutions are going to be the ordered pairs that make both equations true. Quick review on forms so we can identify those, because we are going to be doing graphing. So when we have the mx plus b, that is slope-intercept form, and we're going to, for graphing, start with a y-intercept, then apply the slope. Now, if you have an equation that looks like this, where you have the x, then the y, then the equal sign, that's going to be standard form. So the way we graph those is by using the x and the y-intercepts. So looking at this system of equations here, we are going to solve it by graphing both lines. So this is in slope-intercept form, mx plus b. So when we go to graph that, we're going to start on the y-intercept. That's the b. That's going to be 1. And now we apply the slope. So that slope here is 2. So thinking rise over run, that's going to be up 2 over 1. And then there's our line. So this red line here represents all the ordered pairs that make the top equation true. Now let's look at the bottom equation. That's going to be a 1/2 x minus 2, y-intercept is negative 2. And then the slope, that's going to be up 1, right 2, up 1, right 2. Draw that line there. And now we have all the ordered pairs that make this equation true. So the solution to make both equations true is going to be right there where they intersect. So that's going to be the ordered pair, negative 2 on the x and negative 3 on the y. So there's the ordered pair that makes both equations true. All right, go ahead and pause the video and try this out on your own, then come back, see how you did. So we are going to graph both lines here. For the top, or the red equation, negative 3 is going to be the y-intercept, so that's going to be right there. And then the slope, negative 2, so thinking rise over run, that's going to be down 2, right 1, down 2, right 1, goes there. Draw the line that represents all the ordered pairs that make this equation true. Now for the blue equation, or the bottom equation, y-intercept is a positive 2, right there. And then for slope, that's going to be up 1, right 2, up 1, right 2. Another dot there for a second point. Draw the line that represents the ordered pairs that make the blue equation true. So the point on the graph that makes both equations true is where they meet, where they intersect. So right there. So negative 2 for the x and 1 for the y. So the ordered pair that makes both equations true, negative 2, comma 1. Looking at this system here, we're going to graph both lines to find the solution, or the ordered pair that makes both equations true. The top equation, y equals 2x minus 1, it is in slope-intercept form, mx plus b. And so we're going to find the y-intercept and then apply the slope. So y-intercept, that's a negative 1 right there. Slope is 2, so rise over run, that's going to be up 2 over 1. Another point there. Draw the line for the list of all the ordered pairs that make the red equation true, or the top one. And now let's graph the second equation. So here we go. So we have, this is in standard form. So we have the x, the y, then the equal sign. So our strategy for graphing is going to be different because it's a different form. So in this case here, we're going to graph by intercepts. Okay, so for the x-intercept, we're going to divide by negative 3, the coefficient of the x. So we're doing 12 divided by negative 3. That's going to make a negative 4 for the x-intercept. So right there on the graph. Now for the y-intercept, same thing. Now this is why it works. This is why we can just divide by 6. So if we look here, the y-intercept, the x value is 0, so we can actually replace that there. So negative 3 times 0 is just 0. So this is why we can just divide by 6 in order to find that y-intercept. So we're just doing 12 divided by 6. That's going to make a 2 for the y-intercept, shown here on the graph. Now we draw that line there. our solution is going to be where the two lines intersect right there, because again, the blue line is the all the ordered pairs that work for the blue equation, and the red line is all the ordered pairs that make the red equation true. So the point that makes both of them true is going to be right there. So the x value is a 2 and the y value is a 3. So there's the ordered pair that makes both equations true. All right, go ahead and pause the video, give this one a try, and then come on back. So the top equation, we're going to graph, so that way we can find all the ordered pairs that make this one true. So that's going to be 3 on the y-axis, 3 on the y-intercept, and then the slope is down 2, right 1 when we're thinking ordered rise over run. And so there's our line for the top equation, bottom equation. This is in standard form. So for graphing these, for the x-intercept, we're going to divide by negative 4. Negative 16 divided by negative 4 makes a positive 4 right there. And then for the y-intercept, we're going to divide by 8. So negative 16 divided by 8 makes a negative 2. So there's the line for the bottom equation there. So again, this is just a list of all the ordered pairs that makes the bottom equation true. This is all the ones that make the top equation true. So the solution that makes both equations true is right there where they meet, where they cross, where they intersect. So the x value is a 2, the y value is a negative 1. So the ordered pair that makes both equations true is 2, negative 1. So just remember, when we're graphing these linear systems of equations, graph both lines, and then the solution is going to be where the two lines meet, cross, touch, or intersect. And that's going to be the ordered pair that makes both equations true.